Well, creating alignment simply actually means that people do the things that they have to do in the context of the strategy from the point of view of an organization. However, we are living in a changing world, and actually nowadays it is required that managers in organizations realize that people will only do the things in line with the strategy that they aim to achieve if people simply have an answer to the question, what's in it for me? So are there mutual rewarding benefits for stakeholders inside the organization and outside the organization that really can be provided to them in a convincing way? So that's how companies nowadays can create alignments. Well, the alignment factor is a little bit of a joke, of course. You know, you have all these fancy television programs now with the X factor and all the human factor and all these type of things. And actually, it simply means that organizations have to have a specific characteristic that distinguishes them from the crowds. So that really creates something extra that makes them attractive. And something extra actually means two things. You consider your stakeholder to be the key person that you have to satisfy in their needs to have an answer to the question, what's in it for me? And you have to be, and you have to deal these people, you have to treat these people in a respectful way. So if you have these two things, you have the alignment factor. Reputation, in my opinion, is a means while alignment is an end. Reputation is a necessity. It's like an hygiene factor. You have to be perceived as respectful, and you have to be perceived as an organization that is really, let's say, appreciated. However, you can be seen as an appreciated organization, but that is not creating a higher performance or long-lasting employability for people that you have to satisfy in their needs to get a salary. So reputation is a means that in the end has to result in alignment. And for that you have to do more than only improve the image of the organization. You have to improve the performance of the organization. To be more competitive is a very broad area of activities that have to be implemented. Let's focus solely on alignment now, because that's what the topic of the book is all about. And simply said, companies have to be open-minded and especially critical about themselves. They have to be critical about whether or not they are able to provide, one, an answer to the question, what's in it for me, for the individual stakeholders, but more complicated, they have to provide an answer and a strategy that balances the answers to all the stakeholder demands regarding the answer to the question, what's in it for me? And that is creating competitiveness in the future, that you really are able not only to satisfy, for instance, the interests of the shareholders, of the individual customers, but of all groups that you depend upon. And that is the alignment factor, if you have that as an organization.
It's clear that if you look at the developments in the world, that training, education is vital aspects of improvements in individual human lives, but also at an organizational level and even at a country level. If you are not open-minded towards learning new experiences, new insights, innovative ideas, then you simply stop at where you were a couple of years ago. So I do think that people need to get a training in all kinds of professions, but if you want to create an aligned organization, you need a basic training in reputation management. So if you ask me the question whether or not the Spanish companies are actually in a not very respected way compared to the other companies in the world, then I simply have to say that I do not agree at all. I do think that Spanish companies actually are in the lead if you look at them from a reputation management and alignment point of view. Spanish companies might have started later with accepting the new developments in the area of reputation management, but they took it up maybe in a later phase, but at the more developed area of maturation. That's point one. Point two, what I see in Spanish companies is that they are much more open-minded
towards learning about new ideas. And last but not least, and I think that's a vital aspect that is also contributed by the Corporate Excellence Center, is creating a joint effort in learning and implementing the learnings in the daily practice. And I do say that I really compliment the Corporate Excellence Center in doing these type of things in the area of reputation management and alignment, because I think that is a benchmark that many countries can follow.